Hello students, welcome back to our today's teaching learning session. As you know that we have already gone through the detailed explanation of the poem Keeping Quiet composed by Pablo Neruda. It is time to discuss about the literary devices used in this poem and the questions which are asked in examination based on this poem. As you know that a stanza is provided in the examination and based on that stanza four questions are asked. Okay, one out of them is generally found either regarding the name of the poem and the poet it has been composed by, and one question is generally asked regarding the literary devices, or you can say figures of speech employed in that poem. So the first question becomes the who, or you can say the stanza has been extracted from which poem. So you must know the name of the poem is Keeping Quiet. Okay, you must know the spelling also. What is the name of the poet? Pablo Neruda, a Chilean poet. Chilean means he belonged to country named Chile, which lies or located in the South American continent. Now let us go ahead with the use of literary devices. As we know that the rhyme scheme of this poem is not existing at all. There is no rhyme scheme. If you go through the poem, you won't find any rhyme scheme. So there is no rhyme scheme, and this poem has been composed in free verse. Okay, free verse. When there is no rhyme scheme, then the term used for that is free verse. Next, figures of speech. That is, very first figure of speech employed is we will count to 12 and we will all keep still. Means we will. In this, we sound produced by means of W letter, that is consonant. It is repeated, so it is alliteration figure of speech employed here. So I have mentioned already, we will stands for alliteration. Thereafter, in the next stanza, for once on the face of the earth, let's not speak in any language, let's stop for 1 second, means let's word has been repeated in the beginning of two consecutive lines, and this becomes an anaphora figure of speech. Okay, anaphora. When same word is repeated in consecutive lines, means in two lines put together, and the first word is repeated, in that case it becomes anaphora. If the same word is repeated in the same line, okay, that when it exists more than twice in the same line, that time it becomes a repetition. Okay, repetition. But when it comes on the beginning of two lines, then it is known as anaphora. Never forget this. Okay, next, there is a word used, arms, and not move our arms so much. Arms here stand for two meanings. Okay, first one is the part of human body, and the second one is arms and ammunition. If you have ever heard about this, arms and ammunition used for the weapon system, which is used in fighting a war. So arms here stands for two meanings, human body part and weapon, w-e-a-p-o-n, weapon. Okay, so this is pun. Whenever a word confers two meanings, then it is known as pun, figure of speech, P-U-N, pun. Next is, it would be an exotic moment without rush, without engine. Just now I discussed about the repetition of a word in the same line, without. Okay, so without and without, it becomes repetition. Okay, without and without has been repeated in the same line, so it becomes repetition figure of speech. And by the word itself, it is quite clear what does it stand for. What does it stand for? Repetition means Repetition means repeat or existence of something twice or more than twice. Okay. Thereafter, we would all be together in a sudden strangeness. We would, again the consonant sound, we would means W consonant has produced V sound, which is that is an alliteration. Okay, so we would here stands for alliteration figure of speech. Thereafter, in sudden strangeness means the sound S has been repeated. Okay, consonant sound of S has been repeated, that is twice. So it is also alliteration figure of speech. Dear students, learn these figures of speech by heart because it is very important from exam point of view. Okay, definitely you are going to be asked one such question that belongs to figures of speech, and certainly you will find a stanza because it is according to the distribution of marks in CBSE, that you will definitely find a stanza on the basis of which four questions will be asked, and one is generally asked regarding the figure of speech employed in that particular stanza. Next is fisherman in the cold sea. Cold sea, okay. So cold sea is an imagery, and fisherman is symbol of the people who create or cause destruction to humanity, destruction to nature. Okay, it encompasses the whole human race, which belongs to the class of people generally cause destruction, generally cause problem to human race. So it is a symbolic imagery. Okay, fisherman, a symbol and imagery, symbol of all hunters and people who cause destruction. I have mentioned the meaning also here so that it can be easy for you to learn it. Cold sea is an imagery. Thereafter, man and the man gathering salt would look at his hurt hands. Very important, because his hurt hands, that is consonant H has produced a sound which is repeated thrice, so it becomes alliteration figure of speech. Alliteration figure of speech. Let us move ahead. Those who prepare green wars. Okay, whether here green war is also a symbol of destruction of nature. Those here stands for the people who belong to the political class. Okay, these scientists and over ambitious people. Okay, thereafter, wars with gas, wars with fire. Again, wars word has been repeated twice, so here it becomes the repetition figure of speech. Thereafter, you can take the screenshot of this page because I have mentioned each and every figure of speech employed in this poem. Wars means repetition. Thereafter, victory with no survivors. Victory with no survivors. A victory, somebody has proved to be victorious, but with no survivors. There is nobody alive. Thereafter, means a war has been fought between two sects, okay? Two parties, or you can say two armies, two sides, but after that war, there is nobody left over to enjoy the victory. So two ideas which are opposite to each other have been put together or have been juxtaposed in the same line or same sentence, which becomes the figure of speech known as paradox. Okay, victory with no survivors, paradox. victory. One side it is saying that it is a victory, on the other hand it is saying that there is no survivor. So if there is nobody alive, no survivor left on this earth after fighting a war, then what kind of victory it is? Okay, so these are two ideas put together, okay, in the same sentence, same line, and which are opposite to each other, okay, which are contrasting in nature. So it becomes a figure of speech known as paradox. Okay, paradox, two opposite ideas put together in same line or same sentence. You must know this is very important. Thereafter, put on clean clothes. Okay, would put on clean clothes and walk about with their brothers. Put on clean clothes means, clean clothes indicates something which is, you know, without any which doesn't have any objection and which is liked by everybody, means new approach. So this is a metaphor here. Okay, put on clean clothes means metaphor. It stands for new approach of humanity, means the people who are busy in waging wars against each other, which are creating the problem for humanity, will stop doing that any further and will come forward to live with fraternity and a brotherhood feeling. Okay, so that's why this put on clean clothes has been used here, which is a metaphor. Thereafter, brothers, with their brothers. Brothers is here a symbol of fraternity, bhaichare ki bhavana. Okay, brotherhood, symbol of mankind. Brothers means symbol of mankind, so it is a symbol and it stands for symbol of mankind or universal brotherhood, right? Thereafter, in the shade, doing nothing. In the shade means all together in the same sink, okay, in the same sink or same position, in which there is they will come forward with the fraternity feeling to live in peaceful life. Okay, so in the shade is again a metaphor. It is again a metaphor, and I have mentioned its meaning also. As the shade protects us from the harmful sun rays, that is, we protect ourselves from the ultraviolet sun rays, harmful sun rays, and in order to protect ourselves we take the shelter of a shade. Okay, likewise, brotherhood helps us live peacefully, means those people who are waging wars against each other will stop fighting any further and they will come forward, they will, you know, meet with each other to help each other and live peacefully, forgetting all their differences and forgetting all their enmity which existed so far. Thereafter, what I want should not be confused. What I want, here again the consonant sound of consonant W has been repeated, what and want. So it is again an alliteration figure of speech. Dear students, as you know that we are giving our stress mainly on the figures of speech employed in this poem, so we are dealing with the same particularly. Thereafter, so I have mentioned what I want means alliteration. Thereafter, no truck with death. Here truck doesn't mean the truck which is a vehicle which is used to carry the goods from one place to another place. This truck doesn't mean that a vehicle. Okay, truck here means that is association. Okay, association. And no truck with death means the poet has no association with death. He doesn't like death, okay, at any cost. He doesn't want human being to live a life which appears like dead. Okay, so here this is euphemism means a figure of speech used to lessen. Okay, lessen, lessen means reduce, lessen. Misinterpret with lesson, that is something different. Lesson means to reduce, to रिड्यूस टू मिनिमाइज द इफेक्ट, कम करना. ओके, सो यूफिमिज्म इज द फिगर ऑफ स्पीच यूज टू रिड्यूस द इफेक्ट ऑफ समथिंग. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इफ यू कॉल ए पर्सन ब्लाइंड, ओके, हु इज नॉट एबल टू सी, सो इन स्पाइट ऑफ कॉलिंग हिम ब्लाइंड वी कॉल हिम, इन स्पाइट ऑफ कॉलिंग ब्लाइंड वी कॉल हिम विजुअली इम्पेयर्ड. विजुअली इम्पेयर्ड मीन्स ही इज अनेबल टू सी, ही इज अनेबल टू विजुअलाइज द थिंग्स. सो विजुअली इम्पेयर्ड यू नो मेक्स अस अंडरस्टैंड दैट यस, ही इज अनेबल टू विजुअलाइज, ही इज अनेबल टू सी एनीथिंग बिकॉज ऑफ हिज आईज विच आर नॉट गिविंग हिम एनी which by which he is unable to see anything, you can say, right? So if somebody is handicapped, okay, somebody is handicapped means he is either his arm or his leg is amputated, okay, he is unable to walk properly or do something properly because of the distortion of his hand or leg. So in that case, in spite of calling him handicapped, we say he is a disabled person. Okay, so that is known as figure of speech euphemism, to reduce the effect of something. किसी को direct hurt ना करे, किसी को तकलीफ ना पहुँचे, उसकी वजह से हम कुछ दूसरे words का use करते हैं जो कि उसके असर को कम कर देता है, that is known as euphemism. So he has no association with death. So in spite of saying association with death, he is saying no truck with death, because association leads to a feeling of something directly connected to the poet, whereas he is not connected with death. The earth can teach us, thereafter at last this figure of speech exists in our poem, that is, perhaps the earth can teach us. Here the earth can teach us, earth has been attributed with the characteristics of human being as a teacher. We have considered here earth as a teacher, that is, the poet has considered earth as a teacher. So earth can teach us, here the figure of speech employed is personification, because we have attributed the characteristics of a person, so it becomes here personification. This is also very important, earth being attributed with characteristics of a teacher. So dear students, these were the figures of speech, and as far as the questions are based on this poem, we are going to answer them one by one. I have already prepared some points. That is, first question, though there are many questions we will discuss later, we can make hundreds of questions from the same poem, let me tell you, but it is time to discuss the textual questions which are given over here. First, what will counting up to 12 and keeping still help us achieve? It is well described in the poem, and we have discussed that keeping still means the theme of the poem itself is to, you know, to remain, to introspect ourselves, a deep introspection which will help us to establish a feeling of mutual understanding and brotherhood. This is the theme of the poem. Same is the meaning of this question here. It will help us stay away from the life full of hustle and bustle, means a life full of noise, commotion, okay, din. Second point, it will help us introspect ourselves, and it will help us feel togetherness and a feeling of fraternity, okay, brotherhood, bhaichare ki bhavna isse hame milegi. It will help us save the world from disaster and destruction, okay. Human beings are busy in a competition to earn more and more, to make their life more luxurious, okay, and in that they are running a rat race, okay, in that rat race they are causing or a lot of destruction, a harm to the nature, our mother earth. So if we nurture a feeling of stillness, or if we follow the stillness, quietness for certain time, definitely it will help us introspect ourselves, and that will lead to a feeling of togetherness. brotherhood. Next is, do you think the poet advocates total inactivity and death? No. The poet has clearly said here that what I want should not be confused, means it should not be with total inactivity, it should not be confused, it should not be misunderstood, it should not be misinterpreted with total inactivity or life without any action. It is our duty to think, to introspect. So the poet here says, no, the poet does not advocate total inactivity. Advocate means support, okay? Support. No, he is not supporting total inactivity. Rather, to stop the activities responsible for war and destruction of nature. His only meaning behind this total inactivity means, he says that you stop fighting the wars and destructing or destroying the nature. He urges human race to live in peace and harmony, in tranquility. Life is ongoing process and should continue without causing destruction to nature and fellow creatures. That is what he means to say. Life is what it is. It should keep on going. Okay? We cannot compromise with the life that we stop doing anything. In that case, we will be as good as a dead creature on this earth. Dear students, the third question is, what is the sadness that the poet refers to in the poem? This is given here in this stanza. Single-minded about keeping our lives moving and for once could do nothing. Perhaps a huge silence might interrupt his sadness, this sadness, okay? He is talking about this sadness. So, the answer to this is, sadness is caused due to failure of understanding ourselves, okay, or oneself. If we fail and if we are unable to understand ourselves, introspect ourselves, that causes the sadness. And because of a mad race of earning more and more, we are busy in our worldly pursuits to earn more and more worldly pleasures, we are forgetting our duty to our mother earth, our nature, and due to that we are destroying our nature and we are creating a problem for ourselves and our coming generations. So the poet here pleads, he requests the whole human race to understand themselves, to introspect themselves and to analyze what is their duty towards the other creatures and the earth. Sadness caused by misinterpretations of human existence, which leads to death. If we misinterpret our existence, our life on this earth, definitely we are approaching the death. Sadness due to isolated life leading to selfish activities because we stop interacting with each other. If at all we interact with the feeling of enmity. Okay, so we have isolated ourselves. We have started living a life of forlornness, lonely life. In that, we are thinking about own existence only. We think about our selfish deeds. In order to get rid of these selfish thoughts, the poet here says that we need to live a life, okay, which is full of brotherhood. And please don't misinterpret my inactivity, okay, means the meaning of total inactivity. Thereafter, the fourth question comes here. What symbol from nature does the poet invoke to say that there can be life under apparent stillness? Okay, in the last, the poet has said that the earth can teach us. Dear students, let me tell you, earth goes through many changes, okay, throughout the year. There are many seasons which come in cycle on this earth and we enjoy all this. Thereafter, being subjected to many changes, earth is always productive, okay? During winter season in the western countries, mainly European countries, that winter is considered as a, you know, curse. There no sprouting of plants, seeds, nothing happens. But during March and April, the spring season comes and everything which is buried under the earth, which is buried under the snow, comes to life. The earth becomes green, with full of blooming of flowers. So earth is a best example of regeneration of life. Okay. So the meaning here is, the answer to this is, the poet invokes the symbol of automatic self-regeneration from nature. There is life under stillness as the buried seeds sprout during spring season. The seeds which are buried start sprouting during the spring season. Earth, being subjected to numerous changes, still remains alive and productive. Okay? Human beings should introspect to advance for the life free from wars, natural destructions, and inhuman activities. So this was all about the questions. There are so many questions we can extract from this poem, and we can answer based on the phrases and terms used in this poem. So we will discuss all those terms later. Thank you, dear students. Have a nice day.